So obviously you've been cycling with your dad for a really long time, but how did that turn into your career?
I think I was very fortunate, really, that I had someone in my family who had a keen hobby and an interest which kind of influenced the whole family. I grew up watching my dad race, so it was inevitable that when I was old enough to get on a racing bike that it was going to happen. So I feel like I was in a very lucky position to be given that sort of support and guidance. I only ever thought that it would be a hobby. I didn't really believe that I could make a career out of it. And when I was at school, it wasn't as if people said, you know, you should think about being a professional athlete or a full-time athlete. So it never occurred to me. I always took it very seriously, and I'm quite a competitive person. So it developed from there, really.
How did winning Olympic gold feel?
To win an Olympic gold medal is like a dream come true, I'm not going to lie. It's difficult to explain, and even talking about it at this stage, you know, it's a year ago that I retired, pretty much. It feels like it didn't even happen because it was so surreal and so special, like something that, you know, will stay with me for the rest of my days.
What advice would you give to young athletes who dream of being on that podium one day?
I think the biggest part of my journey was not accepting people, restricting what I was capable of. I was told very early in my career that I was too small to be a sprinter, I was too puny, I had no natural acceleration, and lots of things which really knocked my confidence. And I felt like, you know, am I wasting everybody's time? Is this really going to happen? Am I just being stupid? Should I just give up? And I'm so glad I didn't. Don't ever allow yourself to miss an opportunity. Don't think if only, try it. If it doesn't work out, you know you have to move on. But if you don't try, you never know. So I think just have confidence in what you've got and take your opportunities.
And what's the best piece of career advice that you've ever received?
To not beat yourself up. And that's just not career advice, that's life advice, I suppose. I'm very hard on myself. You know, I have high expectations of everything I do. And not always it works out. You know, sometimes you make mistakes, sometimes you don't achieve what you want to achieve, and there's no point sitting around just beating yourself up going, oh, I'm so rubbish, I did this wrong, and I'm terrible for that. So I still try, it's work in progress. Try not to beat yourself up, look at the positives.
So obviously you've retired from cycling now, what's next for you?
At the moment I'm continuing with my bike design at Halfords. I've got a couple of good sponsors that are still supporting me with O2 and Oakley. I have had my own spinning classes at Fitness First, developed them, and hopefully that's going to be an ongoing relationship, which was so much fun. I'd actually quite like to be a personal trainer. I realise that now I've been in a few spinning classes. But I would also really would love to start my own cycle clothing range, mainly because I've been wearing a men's extra small for so long. I feel that something could be done there, but I'm going to give it a try and see how it goes.
So like, is designing something that you're quite interested in? Obviously, you've designed the bike with Halfords.
I really enjoyed the process, the design process. And at school, I really enjoyed art and subjects like that. Unfortunately, all my time was drawn into sports, and I studied sports science at university, and it all ended up going very sporty. But when I want to relax, I like to do quite arty things, quite creative things. So it's making a nice change to do something that appeals to me in a different way.
Phones on silence.
Yes.
How annoying is that?
So I've just got two. I literally every shoe I tried on this morning.
Like
I went to
black ones.
I was like,
oh, I hate that. Toms are the best thing.